So you're looking into real estate CRMs, customer relationship managers, your head got overwhelmed, and so you came to a video to figure out all the answers that you need. What is the best CRM? Why do you need one? What options should you be looking at? So in this video, we're gonna break that down. I'm gonna touch on what a CRM is, why you need one. I'm gonna touch on the different tool sets that you're gonna find in different real estate CRMs, which ones are the best for different types of real estate agents. And then I'm actually gonna showcase 10 different options for you, 5 that aren't real estate specific and 5 real estate specific CRMs that you might want to check out if you need a new real estate CRM. So let's get started. I'm your host, Jeff Bittner. This is the After the License channel. You can find us on YouTube. We've got a podcast and basically all the social media channels. If you enjoyed this video, consider giving it a thumbs up, dropping a comment below, and give us a subscribe. We do a ton of videos like this, helping you, the real estate professional, out. So what is a CRM? Again, CRM is short for Customer Relationship Manager. And at the end of the day, that is what the CRM is. It's there to help you manage your customers and manage your clients. It's there to kind of be the backbone of your business, where you can keep all of your customers, all of your potential clients, you can keep all of the info about them, details you found out about them in a conversation, potential tasks, upcoming tasks where you have to follow up with them. It's to help you keep your business organized. And it's important because as you get busy in real estate, you're going to come in contact with a ton of people. You're going to meet people at open houses, people in your database, your sphere of influence, friends, family, referrals. How do you keep track of all of these people is going to be really dependent on how successful you are in this business. If you just meet someone and drop the ball and don't have long-term follow-up plans in place, you can ultimately be out of this business pretty quickly. So having a system, whatever system it is, having a system for your business can be critical. And so they say the best CRM is the one you use. And the reason why they say it is because it's true. That is an important piece. We're going to talk a ton about different functionalities. We're talking about different options for you. But if you don't use it, whatever your system is, it's not going to be any help for you or your business. So pick a tool that you like, pick a tool that makes sense to you, pick a tool that you're going to use, because the best CRM is the one that you use, okay? So what are the different tool sets? Again, there are 1,000 different CRMs out there for 1,000 different industries, and there's hundreds, it feels like, real estate specific CRM. So let's talk about the different tools that you might actually find in a CRM. Now, every CRM is going to have some basic organization features in there. Ways that you can keep track of your contacts, ways that you can keep track of upcoming tasks, you can assign yourself upcoming tasks, a notes section in there for hopefully keeping notes on that particular customer, that particular lead, and then some details section, right? When's the next time you need to follow up? When's that person's birthday? What's their mailing address? Almost every CRM system that you go with, and again, I'm going to touch on some different ones here in a little bit, and some of them aren't actually CRMs because you don't need a specific CRM to kind of keep track of some of this stuff, but most CRMs have that basic functionality in there, right? Contact info, phone number, mailing address, tasks that you can assign yourself so that you can ultimately follow up and keep track of when you need to touch these people in the future. The second set of functionality that you can look for in different CRMs is advanced communication. Okay, I'm calling it advanced communication, but this looks like a lot of different things in different CRMs. So some CRMs connect with your email and actually will pull in all of your emails from that particular contact. Other CRMs have drip campaigns, so you can send out newsletters or a constant drip of emails or text messages to those particular clients and or leads. Again, pretty cool functionality if you need it and if you use it correctly, okay? And then the third kind of major set that you'll see in some real estate specific CRMs is an attached website, which comes with its own kind of perks and benefits. So which agents need what? If you're a more traditional agent and you have just a small to medium pool of clients that you're working with, and maybe you work with clients and past clients and referrals and friends and family, maybe you have 25 to 300 contacts. For you, more often than not, a basic CRM is going to work. Something that just has basic organization tools, because you just ultimately need to keep track of those people, come up with a plan to follow up with them, assign yourself tasks and dates to do that follow up, and then actually go and do that follow up. So a basic CRM with some basic communication tools is probably going to work for you if that is kind of the business that you're in. Now, if you're meeting with, you know, more people than that, maybe you meet 25 people at an open house every weekend and you're doing open houses every single week, then you might need to look at some of the more advanced tools where they have automatic emails or automatic text messaging. And then finally, if you're going to do any type of online lead gen, so Facebook ads, Facebook marketing, Google ads, Google marketing, right? Where your inbound leads are plentiful, right? Maybe you're getting 20 leads or 50 leads or 100 new leads a month. Then guess what? You're probably going to need a tool that has some of that more advanced functionality that's tied to a website for a variety of reasons. And we'll touch on those here in a second. So what are our different CRM options? Again, I'm going to break down 10 tools that I think are potential options for you. Five are not specific to real estate and five are specific to real estate. So let me share my screen here. There we go. You should be able to see it. So the first option in terms of CRM, and I've seen a ton of agents use just a spreadsheet and have a ton of success. Again, Google Sheets is a great option. If you just want to keep track of who you're connecting with, then next time you need to follow up, you just need to keep track of basic things like their mailing address or their phone number or their email. For the agent who needs kind of that basic functionality, something like a Google spreadsheet can work fantastically. Another option kind of in this realm is a tool called Airtable. Airtable is a spreadsheet on steroids. So if you like that spreadsheet feel, you might want to look to Airtable. Now, with my real estate team, we actually use Airtable. I personally use Airtable for a lot to keep track of my agents, to have them fill out forms. And so Airtable can have a ton of functionality. I don't use it as a CRM, but I know that some people do. So again, if you like that spreadsheet feel, Airtable can be a fantastic CRM for your real estate contacts with some additional functionality in there. Now, again, in kind of that basic CRM mode, but that's not actually really a CRM, is an option like Trello. I know a ton of real estate professionals who manage their business in Trello. And one of the reasons is because it's free. Just like Google Sheets is free, Trello is free with some basic functionality where you can go in and you can really manage your projects. And in this case, in real estate, those projects might actually be your clients or your customers. So again, I know, and I've talked about Trello a ton on some of my other videos. I love it. I've used it for a variety of projects. I've in the past kept my personal to-do list in there. Well, I know people who keep their real estate contacts in there. They keep their contact info. They put to-do dates. They actually manage their transactions in there. So again, not a true CRM, maybe not something I would recommend for everyone, but if you like the visual kind of Pinterest feel of the project management tool Trello, that might be an option for a CRM for you. Now, let's jump into more of the traditional CRMs. Again, there are a million different options. If you just Google customer relationship manager, you're going to see a ton of options. Salesforce, Copper, which I've got shown here, Nutshell. There's literally a million of these things. And so again, you can do some exploring. Here are a couple of options that I've heard great things about and I played around with. Copper is fantastic because again, it's more of a traditional CRM. It ties in directly with your email so that you can actually see contact deals of that participant, of that particular customer in your Gmail account, which is, again, I think fantastic. We talk about ease of use and the ability to actually use your CRM. Copper might be the easiest to use because in a lot of cases, you don't actually have to leave your email to access those details. So if you're looking for just more of a basic CRM, again, one that just has the ability to kind of keep track of lead details and tasks, and when you've kind of reached out to people, look to Copper. Now, again, there is that Gmail functionality where it's pulling in emails from those contacts and displaying their CRM contact right next to it. So I really like that functionality. Now, Another one kind of in that same realm is something called Pipe Drive. Now, I haven't personally used it, but I've heard of a lot of people who love it. Again, a basic CRM where you can come in and you can add contacts, keep track of them. Now, this does have more of a sales funnel type feel to it. That's why they call it Pipe Drive, kind of like a pipeline where you can keep your contacts and deals in different kind of columns. So you can keep track of which ones are customers, which ones are maybe an escrow, which ones are 30, 60, 90 days out. So if you're looking for more of a salesy feel, Pipe Drive might be the option for you. Now, these next set, again, we've touched on five kind of not real estate specific CRMs and a couple of them that aren't actually CRMs, but could be used as CRMs. Now we're gonna get into the category of real estate specific CRMs. Now, again, there are a million of them. I can't touch on all of them in this video, but I want to give you a couple that I've tested out that I like that I think have a ton of functionality that might be beneficial for you. So the first one is LionDesk. LionDesk is great because it has a pretty low cost to it. Now, you're gonna have to check out the pricing when you watch this video, but historically, LionDesk has been on the cheaper end in terms of pricing, but it's also had a ton of functionality. So when we get into these real estate specific CRMs, a lot of these are going to have that kind of advanced communication piece where they either have email drip campaigns, the ability to do newsletters, and in some cases, text message drip campaigns, which is really, really, really powerful. But again, LionDesk is great because it can help you integrate all of your different lead generation sources. It's all in one spot. You can do those drip campaigns and you can stay in front of your clients. Now, the next real estate specific option, and it's one that I love, and it's really, really, really user friendly, is a tool called Follow Up Boss. Follow Up Boss is fantastic. It is one of my favorites in terms of look and feel and ease of use. Now, again, pricing on this one's gonna be more than LionDesk. I think for an individual version, you're looking at $50 to $70. Again, you have to check pricing when you watch this video. But a ton of fantastic teams really rely on Follow Up Boss. Now, one of the fantastic parts about Follow Up Boss is all of the integrations from all of your different leads, whether you get Zillow leads or inquiries on your website, all of those are gonna flow into your email and automatically get added to Follow Up Boss. Again, really great tool, some fantastic developers behind this one. I really loved using it. It just didn't have all of the functionality that I was looking for in terms of having a website and some of these other things that some of these other tools that I'm gonna talk about do have. Now, the last three on this list, and at the very end, I'm gonna tell you the one that I use for myself and my real estate team here in Phoenix. The last three are more robust systems. They have all three levels of functionality, right? The basic things, you're gonna be able to keep track of your contacts. They have email and text message drip campaigns, and they have the advanced website functionality. Now, I'm just gonna show you the first one, Sync, but I also wanna talk about the pros of having a website tied to your CRM. Again, if we think about keeping track of our contacts, if we have our contacts in one spot, and then we have access to the MLS and what we're sending to our clients and our customers via the MLS in another system, our multiple listing service, those two systems don't talk to each other. So we can see they're looking at the MLS in one place and we're trying to keep track of them in another place. When we use a tool, a CRM that's connected to a website, we can join those two. And what makes that so powerful, why that is such a benefit for you, is if you can look at your neighbors, your friends, your family, if you can add them to your CRM, set them up on property alerts from your website, and that website can keep track of what properties they look at, what properties they favorite, what areas they're searching in, what parts of town they're trying to find homes in. Guess what? You get all of that info, you get all of that feedback, you get all of that data relayed back to you in your CRM without having to ask. Again, it's just a little bit different than setting up property alerts from your MLS. I would have clients and I would set them up, Scottsdale, 3-bed, 2-bath, but I didn't actually know if they maybe also wanted to look in Peoria or Phoenix or a specific type or a specific part of Scottsdale. When you have it tied to your website, again, all of that data gets passed back and forth in a really fantastic way so that you have everything you need in terms of follow-up, and building good rapport with the lead. I wanted to jump in here and just mention one of the biggest perks of having a website tied to your CRM is also the ability to generate leads, right? You can go out and promote the website, people register on that website, and they land in your CRM. So I forgot to kind of mention that in my first taping, so we'll cut this in. So all three of the next CRMs that I'm going to talk about have that website functionality built in. They're not going to be cheap. A lot of them have a pretty penny tied to them, but do know that there are a lot of teams that will provide this to you if you join a real estate team. And there are some real estate brokers out there who are giving away these kind of enterprise tools to their agents. So the first one is Sync. Again, great tool used by a lot of teams across the country, fantastic website and a fantastic CRM. Again, they're tied together. This tool does have that advanced functionality where it's got email drip campaigns, text message drip campaigns, all of the data from the website gets pulled into the Sync CRM there. Another option is KV Core. Now, what's great about KV Core is KV Core has partnered with a ton of real estate brokerages. And so there are a ton of real estate brokerages now who are actually giving KV Core to their agents for free. I'm an agent at eXp Realty and all of our agents get KV Core. So if you're interested in learning more about eXp, please don't hesitate to reach out to me. Happy to kind of tell you more about that, right? But KV Core is fantastic because, again, it's got a lot of that stuff built in. And what's also great about KV Core that some other tools don't have is it has some additional functionality on the back end where there's some automation working for you. And that's what makes KV Core great. KV Core has some functionality built out where if your lead looks at the same property three times or favorites a home or requests a showing, some automation kicks in where automatic text messages go out, automatic emails go out. So some of that follow-up is being done on the back end for you. And that is what makes our lives easier, right? If we don't have to worry about every single text message, every single email, we can ultimately have more success in the real estate industry. So KV Core is a fantastic option if you're part of a team or a brokerage that provides it for free, even better, right? Really robust tool with a ton of functionality. Now, I want to show you the tool that I've used and I've decided to use with my team and what I use personally, and that's a tool called Chime. Again, very similar to Sync and KV Core. It's got the text message capability. It's got the drip campaigns in there. It's got a fantastic website. The reason why I picked Chime for my team is the ease of use, right? It is really user-friendly, and they have some AI technology in the back end that will actually text message your leads for you, right? So again, an added feature. If you've gotten Chime from your brokerage or from your team, you might wanna see if you can kind of enable that for your personal leads. But Chime is great because, again, it's got the AI functionality who will actually text message or message your leads for you as soon as they hit your platform. You can build robust drip campaigns. It's got a fantastic, great looking website, and they're constantly rolling out updates to make and improve their system. So guys, this was 10 different real estate CRMs. I hope I gave you a nice overview and gave you some options that you can go and explore. What questions do you have about which different tools, which ones do you like, which CRMs do you use the most? Drop a comment below. And make sure you're checking out my video on the housing market. I just released one. I'll put a link up here a couple weeks ago talking about interest rates and the shifting market. Make sure you go check that video out. As always, if there's anything I can help you with, please don't hesitate to reach out, and I'll catch you on the next video.